I was explaining the situation to Master Yoda.
Kidnapped. Jabba the Hutt's son has been.
How much damage is there?
A Separatist command ship is fleeing the battle.
Execute battalion! Take AT-AT-300! Let's go!
Commander, what is the damage level to the enemy ship?
Did you really think I would leave the hyperdrive unguarded?
You must evacuate! That is an order!
Master Skywalker taught me never to let up when the Tinnies are on the run!
To really bring the characters to life, you of course need really good actors, and I think we're really lucky on Clone War to have a bunch of great actors, not just in the movie.
The droid General Grievous has our forces spread thin.
But also the series.
General, we await the Malevolence at the rendezvous point.
The series is exciting because the cast can really build on their characters over a long period of time. When you're voice directing, the first moment is really to talk about the characters' questions they have about the script. I give them a big breakdown of the episode. We talk about what their characters are going to be like, why their characters are motivated to do what they're doing, especially the new characters. And it takes a talented person because they have to imagine everything around them, what the rooms they're in are like, what the vehicles they're in are like. With really nothing to look at, maybe we give them a drawing of their character. They're picturing in their mind what this is all going to look like.
I'm a lizard.
He's almost like Cadman's little pet.
But like willing to go into dangerous situations.
I try to paint the best picture I can for them, but then let people add to it.
Obi-Wan! Come in, Obi-Wan!
Anakin, I'm afraid Grievous is onto us.
Yeah, we noticed.
We'll rendezvous back at the Twilight. The fleet must engage the
Obi-Wan, come in! Obi-Wan!
Our voice actors are also talented. They can do multiple things. Tom Kane, he plays several characters in the show.
Before the battleship Malevolence could destroy an Outer Rim clone medical base, a Republic strike force, under the command of Jedi General Anakin Skywalker, crippled the warship, disabling its dreaded ion cannon.
General Skywalker, one of the engines of that frigate has exploded.
The communication center, perhaps, their target is.
Because some of them play multiple characters, I think it brings an awareness where they're not just walking in cold, they're bringing knowledge of other episodes and other things they've experienced to Star Wars. Matt Wood, he's a huge fan, and he will play many droids in the Clone Wars.
Coordinates are locked. Hyperdrive is engaging. We have a problem.
You know, he electronically modifies his voice, and that's really interesting when you hear Matt's regular voice versus who he is as General Grievous.
Do you really think I would leave the hyperdrive of this ship unguarded?
I thought the hyperdrive was fixed!
The Navic computer is heading us right into the moon!
Fools! Reset the Navic computer!
Quick, reset the Navic computer!
No! No! Reset it! Reset it!
Perfect. We really have a great time, and a lot of fun comes out of it, and you know that's when I know the thing's really working well.
This is what happened. Very, very dramatic moment. Obi-Wan's right there, walks up to Cody and says, Cody, battle positions!
Cody, battle positions!
I thought, you know, he had to scream so he could hear through the helmet. No.
I gotta let you guys do your own commentary track. That'd be hilarious.
You should let us do it in the characters. See?
Oh, yeah, that would be great. Like, you're watching it.
Yeah, yeah.
I don't think, I look quite good in this, don't I? Oh, yes. Now, you, Anakin, you could use some hair gel or something.
No, thanks.
As a director of animation, it's important for us to get the actors all in the studio at the same time so they can get energy off each other, so they can interact, and really interact.
You will get on the gunships when we arrive! Where's Ahsoka?
About 6 click-sees, Master! We've engaged the enemy and we've got them on the run!
Sometimes I'll have to ask them to get physical and really stretch their body out, or if they're in the middle of a windstorm, you have to be shouting like you're speaking over something loud going off. There's a battle. You have to describe the flak explosion so they know to shout. Of course, Ahsoka, she really is this genuine, nice person, and Ashley really brings that to the character.
I know I was wrong. I just got so caught up in my own success, I didn't look at the battle as a whole. I wasn't being disobedient, I just forgot.
Henry Gore and I really thought we had a couple really good Padme candidates when we were interviewing for Padme, and all of a sudden, Kat Tabor said Annie off stage. We both looked up like, wow, that was just right.
Annie? My goodness, you've grown.
So have you.
She's a huge fan, so she had studied all the lines, and if I make reference to a scene in the movie, which I'll do quite often, she knows exactly the attitude and the temper I'm talking about.
Let's go 201 all the way to 208. What's happening here? You've just been pushed by the Force into the elevator. The door is shut. Anakin chops those battle droids down. So then, it's like after this moment of chaos, you two get to have a little moment of fun. A little tongue-in-cheek joke moment.
Ever since I've known you, you've been playing with droids.
Matt and James playing Anakin and Obi-Wan, once they were trying to read some lines back and forth, and I was like, it's just not, just doesn't quite feel like you're friends. And then between takes, they were just chatting with each other, kind of fooling around, and I'm like, that's exactly what you need to do. See, the way you guys are joking now, that is Anakin and Obi-Wan.
Anakin, you're doing things while Obi-Wan's trying to talk to you. So you're like fixing the ship, hitting the switches, you're hitting other things, pulling the throttle. So when you're saying, I don't have a backup plan yet, you know, so you're doing other things. Basically, you're doing that because you are prepping the ship, but you don't want to appear to Obi-Wan like you don't know what you're doing.
It's all about being specific and communicating with them to get the best possible result. And luckily, I think we get that.
And let's just do it again, 114 to 126.
I trust you've already formulated a brilliant plan to rescue the Senator.
As a matter of fact, I have.
But do we have a plan B? Every operation needs a backup, Anakin.
I don't have a backup. Yet. But I do have a plan for getting on that ship.
Really?
The enemy sensors are obviously damaged, so we'll sneak in behind them and dock at the emergency airlock.
That's your plan? Just fly there, land, hope they don't spot us, and walk in the door?
Basically.
Oh, brilliant. Let's get going.
Great. I really liked that. We're not even gonna do it again.
It's crazy.
I know, I'm just running reckless now. Safety? Who needs a safety? I got it.
Dee Baker is every single clone you hear. Rex has a little bit of a different sound than Cody has a different sound than a clone I can't tell you about because it's still top secret, but you know, he does a great job with that.
I've rounded up three brigades, Si. Where are we going?
We're going to board a Separatist frigate, rescue Master Ropel, and recover an archive holocron.
We have no assault craft, sir. Only a couple of fighters in the Twilight. Waiting for orders, sir.
We try to bring a reality to it and a freshness where it doesn't feel like they're reading lines. I just want them to be those people. And I think our cast really brings that.
On archive security? Reflect on your actions, you care.
It's impossible, not to mention deadly.
Perhaps your reputation has been exaggerated.
The communications center will be crawling with Jedi. Why do I need to go in there?
Only members of the Jedi Council are allowed access.
He looks like a Jedi.
Thank you.
Collectively, we have a group of actors that bring a love of Star Wars to every role they play. And that's important in this. We're finding people that believe in this universe and want to be these characters, and that really goes a long way to give the fans the best possible Star Wars experience we can.